Welcome to Study the Bible with me. Today we are starting the book of Ezra. So grab your Bible and let's dig right in. Ezra chapter 1. Now in the first year of Cyrus, king of Persia, that the word of the Lord by the mouth of Jeremiah might be fulfilled, the Lord stirred up the spirit of Cyrus, king of Persia, that he made a proclamation throughout all his kingdom and put it also in writing, saying, Thus saith Cyrus, king of Persia, the Lord God of heaven hath given me all the kingdoms of the earth, and he hath charged me to build him an house at Jerusalem, which is in Judah. Who is there among you of all his people? His God be with him, and let him go up to Jerusalem, which is in Judah, and build the house of the Lord God of Israel. He is the God which is in Jerusalem. And whosoever remaineth in any place where he sojourneth, let the men of his place help him with silver and with gold and with goods and with beasts, beside the freewill offering for the house of God that is in Jerusalem. Then rose up the chief of the fathers of Judah and Benjamin, and the priests and the Levites, with all them whose spirit God had raised, to go up to build the house of the Lord which is in Jerusalem. And all they that were about them strengthened their hands with vessels of silver, with gold, with goods, and with beasts, and with precious things, beside all that was willingly offered. Also Cyrus the king brought forth the vessels of the house of the Lord, which Nebuchadnezzar had brought forth out of Jerusalem, and had put them in the house of his gods. Even those did Cyrus king of Persia bring forth by the hand of Mithredath the treasurer, and numbered them unto Sheshbazzar the prince of Judah. And this is the number of them: 30 chargers of gold, 1,000 chargers of silver, 29 knives, 30 basins of gold, silver, basins of second sort, 410, and other vessels of 1,000. All the vessels of gold and of silver were 5,400. All these did Nebuchadnezzar bring up with them of the captivity that were brought up from Babylon unto Jerusalem. Chapter 2. Now these are the children of the province that went up out of the captivity, of those which had been carried away, whom Nebuchadnezzar the king of Babylon had carried away unto Babylon, and came again unto Jerusalem and Judah, every one unto his city, which came with Zerubbabel, Jeshua, Nehemiah, Seraiah, Reliah, Mordecai, Bilshan, Mispah, Bigvai, Raham, Barna. And the number of the men of the people of Israel, the children of Parosh, 2,172. The children of Shephatiah, 372. Children of Era, 775. The children of Pahath Moab, of the children of Jeshua and Joab, 2,812. The children of Elam, 1,254. The children of Zatu, 945. The children of Zakai, 703. The children of Bani, 642. The children of Bebai, 623. The children of Azgag, 1,222. The children of Adonikam, 666. The children of Bigvai, 2,056. The children of Adin, 454. The children of Atta, of Hezekiah, 98. The children of Bizai, 323. The children of Jorah, 112. The children of Hashem, 223. The children of Geba, 95. The children of Bethlehem, 123. The men of Netopa, 56. The men of Anathoth, 128. The children of Azmaveth, 42. The children of Kijathajerim, Chephirah, the Beroth, 743. The children of Ramah and Gaba, 621. The men of Michmas, 122. The men of Bethel and Ai, 223. The children of Nebo, 52. The children of Migbish, 156. The children of the other Elam, 1,254. The children of Harim, 320. The children of Lod, Hadid, and Ono, 725. The children of Jericho, 345. The children of Sina, 3,630. The priests, the children of Jedeah, of the house of Jeshua, 973. The children of Imer, 1,052. The children of Pashua, 1,247. The children of Harim, 1,017. The Levites, the children of Jeshua and Kadmiel, of the children of Hodaviah, 74. The singers, the children of Asaph, 128. The children of the porters, the children of Shulam, the children of Etah, the children of Talmon, the children of Akub, the children of Hatita, the children of Shobai, in all 139. The Nithinims, the children of Zihar, the children of Haspa, the children of Taboath, the children of Keros, the children of Siaha, the children of Padon, the children of Lebanna, the children of Hagaba, the children of Akub, the children of Hagab, the children of Shalmai, the children of Hanan, the children of Gidel, the children of Gaha, the children of Reah, the children of Rezin, the children of Nekoda, the children of Gazam, the children of Uza, the children of Basia, the children of Besai, the children of Asma, the children of Mahunim, the children of Napsim, the children of Bakbuk, the children of Hakfa, the children of Haha, the children of Bizlath, the children of Mehida, the children of Hasha, the children of Bakos, the children of Sisera, the children of Thama, the children of Nezia, the children of Hatifa, the children of Solomon's servants, the children of Sotai, the children of Sophereth, the children of Peruda, the children of Jela, the children of Dakon, the children of Gidel, the children of Shephatiah, the children of Hatil, the children of Pochereth of Zebaim, the children of Ami, all the Nethinims, and the children of Solomon's servants were 392. And these were they that went up from Telmela, Telhassa, Cherub, Adan, and Imal, but they could not shew their father's house and their seed, whether they were of Israel. The children of Delea, the children of Tobiah, the children of Nekoda, 652. And of the children of the priests, the children of Habiah, the children of Koz, the children of Barzillai, which took a wife of the daughter of Barzillai, the Gileadite, and was called after their name. These sought their register among those that were reckoned by genealogy, but they were not found. Therefore were they, as polluted, put from the priesthood. And the Tashatha said unto them that they should not eat of the most holy things till there should up a priest with Urim and with Thummim. The whole congregation together was 42,303, beside their servants and their maids, of whom there were 7,337, and there were among them 200 singing men and singing women. Their horses were 736, their mules 245, their camels 435, their asses 6,720. And some of the chief of the fathers, when they came to the house of the Lord which is in Jerusalem, offered freely for the house of God to set it up in his place. They gave after their ability unto the treasure of the work 61,000 drums of gold, and 500 pounds of silver, and 100 priests' garments. So the priests and the Levites, and some of the people, and the singers, and the porters, and the Nethinims, dwelt in their cities, and all Israel in their cities. Chapter 3. And when the seventh month was come, and the children of Israel were in cities, the people gathered themselves together as one man to Jerusalem. Then stood up Jeshua, the son of Jozadak, and his brethren the priests, and Zerubbabel the son of Shealtiel, and his brethren, and builded the altar of the God of Israel to offer burnt offerings thereon, as it is written in the law of Moses, the man of God. And they set the altar upon his bases, for fear was upon them because of the people of those countries. And they offered burnt offerings thereon unto the Lord, even burnt offerings, morning and evening. They kept also the feast of the tabernacles, as it is written, and offered the daily burnt offerings by number according to the custom, as the duty of every day required, and afterward offered the continual burnt offering, both of the new moons and of all the set feasts of the Lord that were consecrated, and of every one that willingly offered a freewill offering unto the Lord. From the first day of the seventh month began they to offer burnt offerings unto the Lord, but the foundations of the temple of the Lord was not yet laid. They gave money also unto the masons and to the carpenters, and meat and drink and oil unto them of Zidon and to them of Tyre, to bring cedar trees from Lebanon to the sea of Joppa, according to the grant that they had of Cyrus, king of Persia. Now in the second year of their coming unto the house of God at Jerusalem, in the second month, began Zerubbabel the son of Shealtiel, and Jeshua the son of Jozadak, and the remnant of their brethren, the priests and the Levites, and all they that were out of the captivity unto Jerusalem, and appointed the Levites from 20 years old and upward, to set forward the work of the house of the Lord. Then stood Jeshua with his sons and his brethren, Kadmiel and his sons, the sons of Judah, together to set forward the workmen in the house of God, the sons of Henadad, with their sons and their brethren the Levites. And when the builders laid the foundation of the temple of the Lord, they set the priests in their apparel with trumpets, and the Levites and the sons of Asaph with cymbals, to praise the Lord, after the ordinance of David king of Israel. And they sung together by causing praising and giving thanks unto the Lord, because he is good, for his mercy endureth forever toward Israel. And all the people shouted with a great shout when they praised the Lord, because the foundation of the house of the Lord was laid. But many of the priests and the Levites and the chief of the fathers, who were ancient men that had seen the first house, when the foundation of this house was laid before their eyes, wept with a loud voice, and many shouted aloud for joy, so that the people could not discern the noise of the shout of joy from the noise of the weeping of the people. For the people shouted with a loud shout, and the noise was heard afar off. Chapter 4. Now when the adversaries of Judah and Benjamin heard that the children of the captivity builded the temple unto the Lord God of Israel, then they came to Zerubbabel and to the chief of the fathers and said unto them, Let us build with you, for we seek your God as ye do, and we do sacrifice unto him since the days of Asahadon, king of Asa, which brought us up hither. But Zerubbabel and Jeshua and the rest of the chief of the fathers of Israel said unto them, Ye have nothing to do with us to build an house unto our God, but we ourselves together will build unto the Lord God of Israel, as King Cyrus the king of Persia hath commanded us. Then the people of the land weakened the hands of the people of Judah, and troubled them in building, and hired counselors against them, to frustrate their purpose all the days of Cyrus king of Persia, even until the reign of Darius king of Persia. And in the reign of Ahasuerus, in the beginning of his reign, wrote they unto him an accusation against the inhabitants of Judah and Jerusalem. And in the days of Artaxerxes wrote Bishlam, Mithredath, Tabel, and the rest of their companions unto Artaxerxes, king of Persia. And the writing of the letter was written in the Syrian tongue and interpreted in the Syrian tongue. Rehum, the chancellor, and Shimshai, the scribe, wrote a letter against Jerusalem to Artaxerxes, the king of this sort. Then wrote Rehum, the chancellor, and Shimshai, the scribe, and the rest of their companions, the Danites and Arphaxathites, the Teplites and Arphaxites, the Akavites and Babylonians, the Susanchites and Dehavites, and the Elamites, and the rest of the nations whom the great and the noble Asnapa brought over, and set in the cities of Samaria, and the rest that are on this side the river and at such a time. This is the copy of the letter that they sent unto him, even unto Artaxerxes the king. Thy servants, the men on this side the river, and at such a time, be it known unto the king that the Jews which came up from thee to us are come unto Jerusalem, building the rebellious and the bad city, and have set up the walls thereof, and joined the foundations. Be it known now unto the king that if this city be builded, and the walls set up again, then will they not pay toll, tribute, and custom, and so thou shalt endamage the revenue of the kings. Now, because we have maintained from the king's palace, and it was not meet for us to see the king's dishonor, therefore have we set and certified the king, that such may be made in the book of the records of thy fathers, so shalt thou find in the book of the records, and know that this city is a rebellious city, and hurtful unto kings and provinces, and that they have moved sedition within the same of old time. For which cause was this city destroyed? We certify the king that if this city be builded again, and these walls thereof set up, by this means thou shalt have no portion on this side the river. Then sent the king an answer unto Rehum the chancellor, and to Shimshai the scribe, and to the rest of their companions that dwell in Samaria, and unto the rest beyond the river, peace, and at such a time. The letter which he sent unto us hath been plainly read before me, and I commanded, and such hath been made, and it is found that this city of old time hath made insurrection against kings, and that rebellion and seditions have been made therein. There have been mighty kings also over Jerusalem, which have ruled over all countries beyond the river, and toll, tribute, and custom was paid unto them. Give ye now commandment to cause these men to cease, and that this city be not builded, until another commandment shall be given from me. Take heed now that ye fail not to do this. Why should damage grow to the heart of the kings? Now when the copy of King Artaxerxes' letter was read before Rehum and Shimshai the scribe and their companions, they went up in haste to Jerusalem and to the Jews, and made them to cease by force and power. Then ceased the work of the house of God, which is at Jerusalem. So it ceased unto the second year of the reign of Darius, king of Persia. We're going to be stopping here today. Next time we shall be starting from the book of Ezra, chapter 5. I'll see you then.